Hello, this is Randy Richard in the shop, and there was quite an interest in learning some Fusion 360 drafting or modeling. I am not an expert at this, even though I have been using AutoCAD product for roughly 30 years almost, long time ago. But anyway, like I said, I'm not an expert at Fusion. I agree with most everybody else that Fusion 360 documentation is really quite horrible compared to others, especially like Onshape. Now, I just use the free education licensed. It says up here education license. And that's, all I need. I don't really try to do this as a business or anything like that. And so they're okay with all this, I guess. But anybody can really get it. So to follow along with the video, you can watch. But if you really want to learn, you have to do. And learning any of these computer programs, any of these drafting programs, I find the best is to have a project. Over here on this side where it says Randy's projects, this is what Fusion, when you open it, this is what it looks like. But one of the other questions is, do you have to have an internet connection? It sure helps. But you don't have to have it. You can draw stuff without an internet connection. Right up here in this here, it says job status. And that will, if you lose your internet connection, this will turn, has a red check or something in it. It'll change and tell you you're offline. But you can hear, you could say working offline. And you can turn it off. There you go. It has a red dot. You're working offline. Now, it won't save your files to their cloud server or wherever they store it. You can save them also on your computer if you want. And the nice thing about being online, it will automatically update your files. I mean, you can save your files. And so far, I haven't found a limit to how many drawings you can save. I have a lot of drawings. You can print your files. You can make drawings. Over here in the Make area, you can do 3D printing. You can make an STL file. And that's what I do. I make an STL file, export it out, and run it through a slicer. They also have a slicer. You can slice it with theirs, and I haven't really used it, but you can make the STL file with Fusion. These are some of the questions that I've been asked. Like I said, the best thing to do is have a project if you want to learn how to do this. I'm going to start here without a project. The project we're going to do, though, through all the videos I'm going to do, we're just going to design our own steam engine. In doing that, but first, we're going to just get some basics down about drawing in Fusion. Or drawing in any other programs, really. But so some of the basics first. Over here on this side where it says Randy's Projects, you can create folders. As you see here, these are folders that I have, right? And there's also some part files. There's some files down here. But create folders, because you might have many projects. We'll go to closing lathe. So you double click that, and it's there we go. It's going to open up, and these are all models, drawings. I have a real bad habit, probably. I call them drawings, but they're models, really, what they are. Now this file is actually a drawing right here. Now you got to follow my cursor. It's the only way I can point here. So this drawing actually is this part right there. Double click that. I say you can double click it, right? You can double click that. It's, of course, my computer doesn't like to. I can't open any of these parts for some reason. Oh, well, that's because I'm offline. Here, let's go back to being online. There we go. That's why. Okay, so we're back online. So let's go to this part here. Now, there is some downfalls to Fusion. If you have many, many parts to a machine you're designing or something like that, where you have lots of parts you want to put together into a bigger machine, Fusion can have difficulties with that. I don't know what the number is as parts go, but from what I understand, it's a lot of parts, but it's very helpful to make assemblies and sub-assemblies when you do make your end up making your model. So I just gotta say that it's when we get to building a steam engine, we could have several sub-assemblies which help build and helps you understand how everything works. So anyway, this is part of the clawsing lathe that I had to redesign because of the bearing issue that goes in this block. I had to make this piece new, just so you know, and then get a new bearing in this block. I didn't want to make this block again, but so as I was able to just modify and repair it a little bit, remachine a little bit the parts and get a new bearing in there and this new piece to fit. But this is several parts here. There's some snap rings in there. You can see a snap ring there, and the bearings in there. These are the types of things you can do. Here, we'll open up the drawing part of it so you can see what a drawing looks like. I don't have the fastest computer in the world, so. There it is. So here's the drawing of that inside piece of it all, right? Of that bearing block. So this is that part right here. Now you go through and put the dimensions in. You click on something and say, oh, that's a diameter, and boom, you know, up here you could say, oh, I want to put a diameter dimensions, and I click on that circle, and there's the dimensions. You're the one who does all this. It'll put the picture there for you, but you have to go through and dimension it. Select different views, orientations, all sorts of everything you think of. Now I have all these other parts in that assembly turned off, so I'm only making the drawing of this one part, what I called the clutch slide. So that's all you see here. But if I had all those other parts, they'd all be on here too, showing, which makes it very confusing. Now you can have also more than one sheet. This drawing I only did looks like just one sheet on, but I could add another sheet to it, and I could have another part on there. I could put the base view on like so. Let's change the side, and there's the base view of the entire assembly of the shaft, or most of it, I should say. And you could say, okay, there it is, right? And then that's all those items in that assembly. And we could turn off things. We could say, well, let's just do the shaft. We could turn off all this other stuff. And there's the shaft. And then we could just dimension that shaft. Or, oh, that's awful small on a piece of paper. You can say, okay, pick scale 1:1. Okay, there we go. 1:1. Linear dimension, and we can say from that corner to that corner, what's that? It's right there. See? Linear dimension, there we go, from there to there. Anyway, so there's a lot of options here, and we'll go through that also, and we'll make some drawings. These are just some ideas. I'm just kind of giving you a quick idea. So to follow along, like I said, you're going to want to get Fusion 360, obviously. So get Fusion 360 on your computer, and you can follow along as you watch the video, and you'll be able to learn what we're going to be doing. So right off in the bat, after you get it, you know, make a folder. And you'll have this blank page, and it says untitled. First thing you can do is click on save and give it a name, right? Test page, tester, test model here. Test model 1, we're going to call it. And it's gonna, this is where it's gonna save it as Randy Masters, Randy's Projects Master File with all these folders. It's gonna be right in the root there. Now you've saved it, so now you're ready to draw. Think of it this way, the blank piece of paper. I need to put something on the paper. I'm gonna make a sketch. That's what just about everybody calls them, sketches now. And that's what you're gonna do. You're gonna say create a sketch. It's going to give you the three axes, the three planes. So you have a X, Y plane, a Y, Z plane, and an X, Z plane. So choose, you're going to have to think two-dimensionally, and you're going to have to think three-dimensionally all at once. So you're going to choose a plane to draw this on. So that's a flat piece of paper. So I'm just going to choose this one for now. Now you can change this later on in your drawing. After you've drawn it, you can change what plane this particular sketch is. Any one part can consist of many sketches. What I try to do is I try to minimize the number of sketches to any one part. I try to build the part with as few sketches as possible to reduce confusion. Makes the parametric side of it work better because everything is related. So now I have this blank piece of paper. It shows me the center of my little vertex here of the X, Y coordinate, because that's the plane I chose. And we can click on the circle up here and say, oh, let's get started right in the middle. We'll put a 3-inch circle, 3.0. And then hit enter, and there is a 3-inch circle. Simple as that. Just fill it out, right? But I really didn't want that. I could double click on the dimension, and I wanted only 2.5 inches. There, we changed it. Pretty simple, right? We want a hole in the middle of a circle, a 1-inch hole. There we go. And now we have a 1-inch hole, right? We're going to go up here to the right, hit stop sketch. Now, when you look at it, it's a flat disc, isn't it? Because it's on the XY plane. I'm going to turn my origin back on so you can see the planes. And you can see where the origin point is, and you can see it's in that plane. Well, this is a tube, a three-dimensional tube. So I'm going to say extrude. And I can click on that part of it, select that part. Now, if I select the whole thing, I won't get a tube, right? If I only select that, and I want it to be three inches long. There, I just put in 3 inches and for the distance, and I have a 3-inch in the tube. Now, down here at the bottom, where these arrows are, and here, it's building a story. This is building the history of what you're making, what you're modeling. So here's the sketch, here's the extrusion. Now I can right click on that and I can rename it. It doesn't have to be sketch one, it could be tube. Name it the part if you want, right? See, now when I hover over it, it says it's the tube. Now I know. Up here is also a history timeline. There's the tube. So that's the sketch. But let's say I want to change it. I can go back, edit sketch. I want that to be 3.5. There we go. Now there's many ways to draw things and make things. This is just one way to make that or to draw that. Let's go back to the tube. We'll edit the sketch. I'm gonna just select that all and hit delete. We're gonna start over here. I'm gonna make the same thing, but what I'm going to do is draw the profile of it as if I sliced it right down the middle. So let's just say here, so it's gonna be 3 inches long, I think it was. And then I'm doing the line command, which is also an L. All I gotta do is hit L on the keyboard, which is way quicker. I hit L, and then I, where do I want it to start? And I go for how high I want. Well, it's 3.5 inches in diameter, It's so that dimension would be the radius, so half of that, right? Well, I can say 3.5, I don't have to do the math in my head, divided by 2, and hit enter. And it will figure that out for me. This, the program will do a lot of math for you, so it really is very helpful. We'll go down here. We'll do that again. Now, if I just go over here and touch up, I don't have to click on it. Just touch it, back off. It look at that. Puts that little line in there, so it's the same height. There, it gives me a reference. Do another line here, and we'll go in there. And then another line. Now, for the bore, it would be a line like that. And the dimension would be, since it's a 1-inch bore, it'd be 0.5, right? Okay, now we don't really need this line here. This is not actually a necessity. Well, so we're going to get rid of that. Now, there's another command up here called trim, which is T. So we can just hit T, and if we hover over that line, or do I want to trim this line? I want to get rid of that. There we go. We'll just get rid of it. So there's our tube if we had a cross section. Let's say stop sketch. Now, okay, down here at the bottom, that extrusion remembered what it had before, right? So we can just go here, edit extrusion. It says missing profile. Here, we'll give it a profile, but that's not what we want, is it? No, that didn't work, did it? Oops. See, it's a square. I don't want that, right? So if I say okay, well, that's all it's going to give me is a square. So that's not the type of extrusion we want. So we are just going to delete that. We're going to select that extrusion and get rid of it. What we want is a revolve right there. We'll turn on the sketch so we see it. See, it disappears. It turns it off automatically. So there, we'll turn it back on. The little light bulb turns it on and off, and we will select the profile, and then we select the axis we want it to revolve around, and that was the x-axis. The angle is a full angle, and it's a new body anyway. We'll explain some of that others later. But anyway, so now we drew the same thing, but we drew it in a different fashion. There's a couple things to play with and think about, and it's very easy to play with these things and to get a basic understanding of what's going on, okay? Now, what I'm going to do next video, we're going to start with an idea, and that's going to be to design our own steam engine, and that's what we're going to start with. So if you have time to practice and get a basic understanding of some of these things, play with these things. There's a lot of commands here. Just explore the commands, what type of ideas are in here, what you can do, and then we'll start working on them. And we'll just start with the basic stuff and build our way up. So thank you guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll be getting more videos out soon.